The House of Representatives has finally sworn in Dorothy Mato 3 months after the certificate of return was presented to her as the authentic winner of National Assembly elections in Consisha Van der Kiav Federal Constituency of Benue State, which initially was awarded to another lawmaker, Eman Embe. The swearing-in ceremony took place during plenary on Tuesday, October 3rd, after two Supreme Court judgments that favored the newly sworn-in lawmaker and laying to rest over 2 years of legal battle for the seat in the Federal House of Representatives.
Do solemnly swear that I will be faithful and bear true allegiance to the Federal Republic of Nigeria, and that I will preserve, protect, and defend the Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. So help me God.
In a related development, the contentious issue surrounding the recent reduction of JAMB score to 120 for universities and 100 for polytechnics, monotechnics, and colleges of education has attracted attention of the House. The motion was sponsored by Honorable Hassan Saleh as he raised concerns that this move by JAMB will only end up encouraging sharp practices in admissions processes in the country, as money bags are likely to hijack process at the stage of UTME examinations.
House also note, Mr. Speaker, that despite the fact that more than 500,000 candidates scored above 200 marks, which represent 50% of the total mark, the Joint Admissions and Matriculation Board still went ahead to announce the 120 cutoff mark, which represents only 30% of the total examination mark of 400, while 100 marks stipulated for polytechnics and colleges of education represents only 25% of the total mark. The House is concerned that its decision is bound to lower the standard quality of education in tertiary institutions, as many candidates who perform woefully in the UMTE examination could secure admissions through nepotism, bribery, and corruption, while many other candidates who perform excellently could be denied admission.
Lawmakers were divided in their views as to the advantage inherent in the proposal by JAMB, as they argued for and against the new policy by the Joint Admissions and Matriculation Board.
After the cut of marks, believe it, she was even afraid to confront me with such marks, because I gave her a target of 300. After that, she met me after the cut of marks was announced by JAMB, that, "Daddy, you've even allowed me to suffer unnecessarily, that now the cut of marks is a minimum of 120. So even if I have 160, I will still have admission. So what are we doing? What are we portraying? That our children should not read? Or are we trying to provide the education for the children of the extremely rich?"
JAMB reduced the cut-off mark because the National University Commission will give, for instance, University of Lagos admissions places of about 1,000 for medical students. And because students don't score, anybody who scores 190, 180, 170, we end up not being admitted because you'll be flouting the law that says cut-off mark is 200. Yet the person has aggregate 9, AA in physics, chemistry, biology, and everything. Because of a 30-minute exam, then that child will be left behind without education. This is the reason these professionals got together and decided that they have to change. Law is made for human beings. They decided in their wisdom that equally in some areas that are educationally disadvantaged is the reason we have the Constitution and we have federal character.
120 is just 20% or 25%. If we are now reducing 40, that is P, pass, E, and we are now taking 25, that is supposed to be F, and we are now saying it's only when you fail JAMB that you will be qualified to go to university. In earnest, that is the explanation, sir. I want to disagree that this is an opportunity of giving people right to study. No, I always say making some people disadvantaged are not the best, because when you say people are disadvantaged or not, in the world of employment, when you are employing somebody, you will not ask the person where you studied from. You are going to assess that person based on what you have on ground.
Integrity of the current registrar of JAR. We also needed to be very careful so that we don't come here, like you rightly said, speak to the camera and take a position. I'm not speaking for you, but that is the truth. People know. Secondly, I also want to believe, Honorable Speaker, that the House could invite this, but we could also be enriched by our colleagues as to which additional stakeholders we will invite, because the stakeholders that are known to know that we are going to invite are the same stakeholders that made and took the decision they took.
Having exhaustively debated the motion on the floor of the House, the motion was referred to the House Committee on Tertiary Education and Services with the mandate to report back in 4 weeks for further legislative input. Emmanuel Higine, PTV News.